folks. This is the third installment of Ace of Spades Food Thread video. I've decided to go out on a limb and bake a rye sourdough boule. Hopefully, if I edited the video correctly, you will have seen the sourdough starter grow, which is a lot of fun to do, and I heartily recommend everybody try it once or twice. Anyway, I've weighed out a couple of things, but mostly I'm going to wing it. So I've got a scale here with a tear setting, which means that you can zero it out no matter what vessel is sitting on it. So first thing I'm going to do is weigh out my salt, because salt is without a doubt the most important ingredient in bread. I've baked bread occasionally without salt, and it's awful. Anyway, 15 grams. Oh, look at that. What a stud. And that goes into the mixing bowl. Now I'm going to add about 285 grams of water. That's a guess. I've made this recipe 10 or 15 times, so we'll see if that works. I use filtered water. I warmed it up a little bit in the microwave. No particular reason. I'm not a professional baker, but it's fun. No, I'm not in the bathroom. Trust me. Well, I went over 298, but that's okay because I usually add more water. Let's roll that around a bit. Now I'm going to add the sourdough starter, and hopefully have enough. I didn't really make that much. I'm shooting for 175 grams. 176. That'll work. I'm just going to whisk that a bit to mix it up. I'm going to add the pre-measured flour because I'm a messy cook and this was just all over the kitchen. So that's 400 grams of white flour and 100 grams of rye flour. Into the mixer. Now I'm going to mix it until it's just incorporated, and I'm going to let it sit for about 20 minutes. It just seems to work out better that way, and then I will continue with the kneading. This is the exciting part. You don't get to see any of it. I do. I'm just waiting to incorporate all of the dry flour, and then I'm going to stop. And that's it. Cover it with a cloth. No particular reason why. I don't know why. I just do it. And I'll be back. So here we are after probably another 20 minutes or half an hour, and the dough feels a little dry, so I'm going to add a little bit more water at the bottom, and just going to knead and see how that works out. I'm going slow at first just until I see what kind of moisture I'll need to add to it, but it looks pretty good right now, so I'm going to increase it to a little bit faster. I don't know if you can see it, but the dough looks pretty damn good. I'm relatively pleased with this batch. As I said, I'm not a baker, so I don't really have any idea what I'm doing, but it sure is fun, so So this looks pretty good. It's a little wet, but we'll see if I can handle it without making a huge mess in the kitchen. Got one of these cool little plastic things that works extremely well. One of the advantages of using a lot of water in the dough is that all that extra water expands, turns into vapor while you bake it, and you get a nice, light, fluffy bread. The problem, of course, is that it's almost impossible to handle easily. So I'm going to transfer it into another bowl that I'm going to oil. I'm also going to oil my hands, because otherwise I can't do a damn thing with this. Yeah, this is quite sticky, as you can see. And this might be a catastrophic failure, but that should be at least as amusing as a successful bake. So all I'm going to do is try to form this into some sort of ball and then put it away for 24 hours or so. Yeah, that'll work. A little bit of oil. There we go. So it's extremely difficult to work with right now, but after a 24-hour fermentation and rise, it is hopefully going to be a lot easier. There we go, and we're all set. Hi folks, we're back through the wonders of that time machine that Ace definitely doesn't have. So this dough has been in the refrigerator for about 24 hours, and I took it out about 3 hours ago just to let it rise a bit more. And it looks pretty good. I'm going to blot some of the moisture because moisture right now is not my friend. This is the toughest part for me, trying to figure out how to make this a reasonable ball of dough so that it can go into the final rise, and this is where I lose it most of the time. So we shall see. Well, looks pretty good. I've seen worse, and it's lovely, lovely sourdough smell here, nice and tangy and redolent of, I don't know, acid, I guess, more than anything else. So, just gonna try to knock this down a little bit and then knead it a bit, form it into a ball that goes into one of these. Nothing out of the ordinary, everybody's seen this before. And the dough feels a little dry, which is a little surprising. I'm not sure why, maybe because it's a little cooler than when I usually make bread, cooler and less humid. But again, I'm not sure. Actually looks pretty good. I don't want to overwork it. Mostly I'm just knocking some of the excess air out of it. So the trick right now is to form it into a tight ball so that I can put it in this nifty little device. And I'm going to flour the hell out of it, because I do not want it to stick. Unfortunately, it has in the past. Not often, but still. Alright, so this is the way I've discovered to do it. there are all sorts of different techniques all over the internet, and I can't do any of them except for this one. Not sure what you would call it, but all I'm doing is tightening the dough into a ball, using as little flour as possible. And then I'm gonna give it a final rise and then bake it. And this has worked actually quite well. I'm very happy. I figured since you were seeing it, it was gonna be a complete and total clusterfuck. But it isn't. Well, there we go. A little bit more flour. Flour toasts in the oven, so it really doesn't affect the flavor. Actually, it does affect the flavor. It makes it taste better. We're all set. Actually, we're not all set. I'm going to cover this with a cloth just to keep it a little more humid in there and let it rise for another couple of hours, maybe 3 hours, and an hour before I want to bake, I'm going to preheat the oven with my Dutch oven inside to about 450. Now, we're all set. And we are back. The dough has been rising in the banneton for 2 or 3 hours, and now all I have to do is transfer it to a preheated Dutch oven. I'm baking at 450 right now, and this is the entertaining part because it's cast iron and it's hot. So here we go. Bingo, that worked well. I'm just gonna cut it and cut deep. Put the top back on and back in the oven. And now we get to the exciting part, which is looking at the finished product. That's not too bad. Let's see. That's cooked. Get that hollow sort of echo, and that tells you that it isn't a big sloppy mess on the inside. I should have cut it more deeply, as you can see, but all in all, pretty good job. And I'll tell you how it tastes with lots and lots of butter.